me put your hands together. Let me tell you what I want you to do. I want you right there. Step right there, no pitch. Turn it off. Let me tell you what I heard the Lord say. He said that we overcome by the blood of Lamb, the word of our testimony. Yeah, I don't know what you want. I'm a warmonger. This is what I hear the Lord said. He said, that when the children of Israel were under war and they was going into the war of Jericho, he said, he tell them to march around for 7 days. He said, on the 7th day, let every voice shout. Look at the neighbor, this one ain't for you. This is one for you. If you're ready for this one, this is one for you. But let me tell you, the enemy is trying to fight us, this week, from Monday. But I can't tell you that we have the victory today.
Yes, Jesus.
Can I tell you that the enemy lost another battle? And I'm prepared to give God some praise. Now, guess what? I don't know if you have a Bible right there in the midst. The man of God showed me right there this morning. And you know what he said to tell you tonight? He said, look at you, my daughter. They're trying to burn down your car. They're trying to cross you on your mind. But look at you. You want a job now. You're finally together. That's enough to give God praise right there.
Thank you.
remains. I was at a church, I made with two people there. God showed me some people coming. High five somebody else. Oh God, this preach word got to preach. But look at your neighbor and say, hey, I'm glad to be here tonight.
I promise you right 9:30 we'll be on there. Oh Jesus, it's done 8:57. 9:30 we'll be on here. Somebody shout glory to God. Somebody give a shout glory to God. Now that's what I want you to do before I begin the word. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, I don't care what they say. I don't care what they do. Now you point at your neighbor. Some of you already need to go to somebody else. I tell them, neighbor, I don't care what they say, nor what they do. I say, don't you care? Listen to the word they say. Don't you dare listen to no name. Because I see the heaven is about to open. The water's about to kiss the earth. You now wait on your minute. I say, my rich minute. God's about to set some books. To bless his people. God somewhere. Say, yeah, with my pursuit. Chapter 28. Boy, that's a powerful word. I saw even those who miss it. Tell me someone. 1 Samuel chapter 28. Now, what's the word with me and me going? Somebody shout glory to God. Be seated.
Lord Jesus. Jesus.
I feel the Holy Ghost moving. Oh, la 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 la. Thank you. Genesis chapter 38. I need 5 minutes, then 5 minutes. Then I look in the dark, somebody's supposed to come in. Genesis 28, then 5 minutes. What about Satanos? Come and be made known you. Genesis 28. Tell me the Holy Ghost in there be. Hallelujah. Some of Genesis 28. Hallelujah, I know. Only you got. All right, I know that. I kept the Holy Ghost. Play with me. Genesis 28. Oh, Shabba! Roto Bosa! Oh, God, I want to come and see all the stories about the house and revival. Genesis 28. Oh, tell me, God said.
And the kingdom has.
1 Samuel, sorry, 28. 1 Samuel 28. Sorry, I say Genesis 20. I apologize. 1 Samuel 20. I just so excited to preach this word.
Amen.
Oh, look at my auntie, my long lost auntie. Hey, auntie. I see you on TV. I said, look at Commissioner Ellison, the green stage, sitting down in front of the floor. Amen. Genesis 20. Somebody, Samuel 20. I know Genesis 20. Samuel chapter 28. And a kingdom for us now. The Philistines gathered their army together for warfare. Say, neighbor. The enemy gathering against you for warfare. Say, to fight with Israel. And Achish said unto David, now thou assuredly that thou shalt go with me to battle, thou and thy men. And David said to Achish, surely thou shalt know what thy servant can do. Oh God, you want me to stop. Say neighbor.
Neighbor.
Come on, look at him and say neighbor.
Neighbor.
You ain't got to talk this thing.
Because they are going to see you why you was qualified for this next level. Come on. Because they think you never fight in here. You ain't got no power, no authority. But David said that this. He said, now I ain't talking this thing. He said, well, when the war comes, you can see what I qualified for. God said to tell you, get ready. Because you about to be sold off to your enemy. Y'all ain't ready for this one. God, you remember Tiffany? You know, when you get ready to fight, you ain't got no time to run over. God said, what I'm doing now, he said, I'm not just trying to put no confusion over you. He said, I'm putting Holy Ghost anger. Some of y'all will be short of patience this week. In other words, I ain't taking no more mess. I ready to fight. When you come at me, you get your condition. But I got the Holy Ghost. And all I made for you to do, you make the first move, and I can finish the rest. Somebody open your mouth and say, glory to God. I'm ready for this thing. Somebody say, glory.
God said, warfare time. Say your name and say, warfare time.
Warfare time.
Why be as Christians so powerful in warfare? Confusion and trouble. You see, I'm just in my corner saying, have thine way, Lord. Are you there in your own corner? Saying to yourself that you power.
Oh, what?
The devil.
Who are you afraid of?
Are you saying warfare?
Amen.
If God said you will be blessed, you will be blessed.
Amen.
If God said no weapon will form against you, no weapon will form against you, shall prosper. And yes, but he said, every tongue that arise shall be what? Yeah. Condemned. So why you listen to your people then? Talking about you then. It doesn't matter. Because warfare, Prophetess Marilyn, is the clear indication that God up to something in the atmosphere. Now let me finish, because you got to understand before we go into this. The word of God says, now something was there. And all of Israel had lamented over him and buried him in Ramah, even his own city. And Saul had put away those that had familiar spirits and the visions of the land. And you all missed that. Because God said, I'm about to expose every witchcraft breaker. They bent the familiar spirit to confine it over who you are. Where your definition was, where your strength was, they've been really serving God for real. But it comes a time that, look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, their warfare ain't working no more. Not like you say, the kabubu and the mubu or the dubu. Everything that they try to put down with you, but you still ain't going down yet. And they mad and they wondering, why the world? You still here.
Jesus.
You step on the rich ground and they expect your foot to swell up. It might have taken you a couple of days.
Right.
But you're still walking.
Thank you.
And the rich ground worker said, you know what? They could be paralyzed a couple of weeks. And they say, for real, and they put it there, put it there. And your leg may got funny, but when you say, rap, I can't have my hand, so your leg straight by now. Watch the stiffity. Now they see you walking straight, they mind with you. Because you ain't going down, but you still kicking. That's why they mind you for it. They said the confusion at your marriage. They might be mad when a day or two in that argument. But the next night, turn off the light. Say, nigga ain't nothing nigga. They spend plenty times, restless nights, trying to destroy him on you. Man, I gotta say it, man. Somebody shout glory to God. Just so far from my heart, I gotta break this down. I can't even go into depths with this. Because you got to understand, say, neighbor, why they hate on me? I say, pastor, why they hate on me so much? I ain't got a dollar to my name, I'm broke. Ah, God. Anybody have some people who owe you?
Because the people know me. Amen. Come on. And you know what they say? They say, oh, Pastor God, of God, because they looking at you and they see the blessing of God all over you. And they trying all they want to keep up with your level. But they don't understand, don't blame me. It's just the favor of God executing on your life. Oh, sorry. What that means is you might have the money, but I got the favor of it. I got the favor. You might have the big house and the nice looking car, but I got the anointing that whenever I go, something got a supernatural happen to me. In other words, God said, you got the ability to open up doors for yourself.
In other words, yes, the revelation. Or is he by it? Keisha. You just looking pretty, you're handsome and smiling. And the devil just hating on you. So you know why they hating on you? Because everywhere you go, you don't change. The environment don't change. You don't. The environment is not changing for them, but the environment is changing for you. Anybody being someplace where when you walk in the room, everybody go quiet. They just talking to you. And they wonder what happened about what they.
They was talking about you, baby. I'm sorry. He said, but what happened is, you gotta understand the level of respect. When the queen come in the room, everybody gotta stand still and keep your mouth shut by, because royalty in the room. Can I tell you that royalty is about to step in their dimension, and they have no choice but to accept who you are as a person. That's why greatness is in the inside of you.
So neighbor, you're destined for greatness. I just laugh at people when they get mad with us. The day for you, but the Lord for me.
You might be laughing, looking good now, but wait a while. I tell people all the time, I've learned how to be patient.
What is patient? Say, neighbor, be patient. Your couple of dollars soon will run out. Minute run up.
How many ways
long?
Amen. Definitely gonna be right there. Say, hey, come, let me pray for you again.
That's how people go. Come on, somebody. And they know it would be even folks. But they get a couple of dollars in their pocket, they smile. Oh, I don't need you no more. That's why God will bless some people. And they don't give them the things that they want. Why? Because he know how they would treat God's folks. But God said to them, he said, the reason why I'm about to bless you is because you might catch all the hell. You had all the humility, one-on-one classes. And now you ain't a discord, people. In other words, that's why some of y'all will give your last. It's not because you don't want to. It's because your heart is right and pure towards people.
Somebody said, keep on being pure. Yeah. But watch this revelation. This is the season now where you gotta be selfish. Remember, David was anointed king. And now Saul, anointing has been transferred to David. Different, and he's in a place now where he's going to the old man. Oh, and the bitch to get a word from the Lord. You hear that?
Yeah,
this is 28. That's me. And the Philistines, the enemy trying to come up against the Dasha.
Yeah.
And guess what they do? Watch verse 7. Watch verse 7. 5. A man saw him, saw the host of the Philistine. He was afraid, and his heart greatly trembled. You know why? The enemy parry now. You know why the enemy parry? Tell me why they parry. And tell me why the enemy parry. Why? Because you ain't there to fight their battles no more. Oh, I understand. The enemy parry because you came from around them. That's why they were so big in our lives, no different. You know, when you step in the place and you are a cousin or friend, and guess what, or a big brother, and you get beat up, first thing they say when they see them, the bell, take your head off.
That's right.
Stop it. Anybody know that? Come on, if your hands, if you know that. Stop it.
Right.
And so, because you know your big brother there, you draw back and what? Now, the enemy ain't got no more backup. And they run and scared, running, because they know that you're about to get blessed in this season. And there's nothing they can do with it no more. They fight it, they curse it, they pray against it. But now, all they have to say, neighbor, rest yourself. Because you worry about the enemy and stress yourself and say, neighbor, time for you to go to sleep. You know why I get my hair cut bald? Because I'm looking young now. You know what that means? I ain't gonna look old with no bag under my eye. I ain't looking like a 52. I ain't gonna go to the gym. Because I will walk up the cruise, them cruise ship. Strong. Ain't nobody gotta lift me up and put me in no wheelchair. Come on, somebody, because I got some airports from here to Clifton Park that I gotta walk in. I got some space that I gotta go. And you gotta understand, God trying to tell some of you, you better know how to get your body straight. Then I'm about to blow your mind in this season at this hour. My name is Adam Church this morning. Now, watch this, watch the docility. Let's go to 7, because we gotta go. Then to Saul and the servant, seek me a woman. Hear that? He said, God. He said, seek me a woman. Seek me a woman. What is your purpose here, sir? What is your purpose here today? What is your purpose here today? Huh? What is your purpose here today? I said, what is your purpose here today? Huh? I said, what is your purpose here tonight? I recognize you. You know that, right? You know that, right? I said, what is your purpose here tonight? Huh? You sure?